It's your second video test. Why don't you introduce yourself?
Hello, my name is Khánh and I'm from the EF panel class from CC Center. And as you know, recently I've been doing a lot of stuff because in about a week later, I'll have the semester test or something like that. And I've been doing a lot of practice and revision. But now I have just attended a class that teach us piano, and I think it's really fascinating.
Oh, so you're learning piano?
Yeah.
How long have you been learning for?
A week.
Oh, nice.
And another thing that I really want to tell you, that I'm having a new hobbies.
Oh, what's your new hobby?
But it's really obvious because
playing the piano.
No, no, it's too obvious because when I came to this club, I do it every day. It's drawing.
Drawing.
But it's now become my true hobbies now.
Oh, awesome. That's really cool.
But two problems that I'm facing during peak traffic hours, that we are wasting a lot of time and a lot of like gasoline and things like that, harming the ozone layer and the environment. So to solve this problem, the easiest way is I recommend people using public transport if they need to go far, or just use the bicycle or go to work by foot. It would reduce the amount of people during the rush hour, and it's really friendly to the environment.
Yes, and it's good for you.
Yeah, and it's good for our health too.
Perfect. Okay, so you're going to choose one from the male and one from the female,
okay,
and decide if they are true and tell us why or why not.
Yeah. I choose number 3.
What is that one?
The stereotype, men worry more about their health than women. I think it's not entirely true because when a man go to his beer club or bar with his friends, I know a lot of men like that. For example, my dad, and he drinks a lot of beer. And beer is not really good for your health if you drink it a lot because of alcohol.
Yeah.
And at home, the person who recommend you eating a lot of fruits and vegetables and drink a lot of water, it's your mom, not your dad. Because I think that nowadays dads are like convenient, so he like really like, do you want to eat pizza or do you like to eat hamburgers? And pizza and hamburgers are not the first choice for your health.
Ah, I agree with you. Very good.
And the female stereotype, I choose number 2. It's women worry more about their appearance than men. It's true. Because the women, they want to express their beauty more than men because men is just like rush and hectic and hurry life,
yeah.
So they don't waste their time on makeup and fashion clothes. They just need a t-shirt and shorts. That is all for them. But women, it's more than that. And they care about their beauty, their
yeah.
appearance, because it's just women.
I hear you. Awesome. Okay, so one challenge that you overcame and give someone a tip who wants to learn the same thing?
Back at the time when I was 7, I used to learn how to ride a bike. And I know to some people it's really easy, but for me it's a very tough job. And I have fallen a lot of time, and I think it's just a nightmare because it's really hard when you fall. And my dad, who taught me how to ride a bike, become more and more impatient because he thinks that I can never ride a bike. Because after 2 months, I got even balance myself. But my mom said that because I'm just too discouraged or something, I'm just too coward and did not believe in myself. And she said that riding a bike will be really easy if you have enough courage and brave. And so after a lot of try, I managed to ride my bike. And it's really convenient and comfortable, and it's also really good for the environment. So I not regret learning to ride a bike.
Awesome.
And a tip for someone who wants to learn this, to ride a bike, is riding a bike is not impossible if you believe in yourself, confident, and have enough courage.
Awesome. So you can ride a bike now?
Yeah, of course. It's easy.
Okay, one scenario and give someone advice.
And choose number two is staying at someone's house. Because I just experienced this.
Yeah.
One of my friends, last week, my friend said that she's going to stay at her uncle's house for a night. And because her uncle had two children and she liked to play with them, so she's invited to stay at their house. So, but she has never stayed somebody's house. So she wanted me to give her some advice. I'm not pretty sure because me too haven't stayed someone's house for a night, except for my grandmother's house, but I'm not camper. But I still give her some advice that if you stay at your friend's house, you should be really, really polite.
Yeah.
Because you're the guest and they are the host. And you should not make a mess because it's really like hard work for the host. And they can become really tired.
Yeah.
And if you make a mess, you should clean it. And you should not say that the food is bad or the house is not clean enough, because the host had to do their best so that they can welcome you to their house and stay. And if you can afford, you should bring a small gift. Or like chocolate or gifts, like something like that. And you should also, after you left their house, you should say a big thank you, and you should send an email that you maybe sometimes they can come to your house and stay.
Awesome.